When the world was new, and dreams had not yet receded from the waking day, dragons ruled the earth. The first dragon was a queen named Mim, and she was the keeper of all who dreamed. Mim circled the world and held her tail in her mouth. As long as Queen Mim held her tail this way, there would be a balance between life and death, and good and evil, and the dreaming would flourish. She watched those who dreamed with care, and all living creatures lived together in peace and harmony, until one day, a spirit known only as the Lord of the Locust became unhappy. The Locust was a nightmare being without shape or form, who could exist only in the spirit world. To enter this world, he would have to take possession of a mortal's flesh. The Locust chose the most powerful mortal of all, Mim, Queen of Dragons. When the Locust entered her mind, the Queen went mad. Balance was lost and the world grew dark. The dream had become a nightmare. To save the world, the other dragons confronted her, and a terrible battle ensued. As the dragons fought, they crashed back and forth, pushing up mountains and carving out valleys. They knew it would be the end of their beloved Mim, but for the good of the world and to destroy the true enemy, they turned their queen into stone, trapping the Lord of the Locust inside of her until the end of times. Later, as the land cooled, the valley was born, but never again would the world be perfect, for the Locust lies hidden just below the surface. Filled with bitterness, the Locust bends the minds of people to his will, and always he creates suffering. Down through the ages, many have tried to kill the Locust and free the Queen, but all have failed, and the land remains in darkness and fear, waiting for the day a hero will come and save them.
Coming round the mountain when she comes. She'll be coming round the mountain
Shut
when
up!
She comes.
Smiley Bone, Phony Bone, am I gonna have to separate you two?
Hey, Phony, the coast is clear.
Look at him. We got chased out of Boneville 2 weeks ago, and he's still moping around. Oh, well, I guess you can whine all you want when you're the richest guy in the whole town.
Ah!
Oops, silly me. Ex-richest.
They can't do this to me! You can't do anything to a rich person that he doesn't want! So a couple of shady business deals went sour. Is that any reason to run the most beloved bone in Boneville out on a rail?
Yes.
Beloved? The mayor declared a school holiday just so the kids could come and throw rocks at you. Oh, bad news, Phone. We're out of water.
That's it! That's the last straw!
Don't get mad at Smiley Bone. This mess isn't his fault.
That's right. The townspeople aren't mad at us. They ran you out of town because you're a selfish little greed bag.
I can't believe this. I'm gonna die out here. Hey, Funk, where are we? Get us out of here.
I can't. We're off the map. I think we're lost.
I'm a respected community leader, a shining pillar of moral strength. How could they do this to me?
Well, at first they...
Who asked you?
He needs to cheer up. Try thinking about something besides your money. Take me, for example. I never had a penny in my life, but I'm not sad. I got no responsibilities. I'm free, free as a bird.
A bird? Ha! More like a mangy stray dog who doesn't eat very often.
Well, true, but you get my point.
Nothing under there.
What a beautiful day! There's not a cloud in the sky!
Good point, Smiley. If we don't find some shade soon, I'm gonna have a stroke.
A little music ought to brighten up the mood around here.
Camptown ladies sing this song, doo-da, doo-da.
You're driving me crazy.
Camptown racetrack's 5 miles long, oh-de-doo-da day.
I think it's some kind of old paper. It's stuck.
What you doing, Foam Bone?
I'm trying to get this thing out from under this rock.
What is it?
I'll tell you after I get it out.
Oh, let me know if it's a piece of pie. I love a piece of pie right now.
Just stand up, will you?
Sure thing, cuz. Let me help you with that. Huh, looks like it's some kind of map.
A map? I'm saved! Give it here!
Give me a dollar first.
What?
Lost in the desert. Give him a dollar.
What does being lost in the desert have to do with anything? I'm not giving up what I have left for that caterwauling hobo.
Caterwaulin hobo? Do you really hate Smiley's music so much?
What, are you crazy? How can you stand it? At least he's over that old gray mare phase.
Boy, you really do hate Smiley's music.
What, are you crazy? How can you stand it? At least he's over that old gray mare phase.
It's only a dollar.
You don't know what it's like to have everything, and then all of a sudden, you have nothing. I'm not giving up what I have left for that caterwauling hobo.
Would you rather spend a dollar or die of thirst out here?
I'm thinking.
We're never gonna get out of here without a better map.
I'm not giving up what I have left for that caterwauling hobo.
Come on, phony. Don't be so cheap.
Cheap? I'm not cheap. Just frugal.
What did you get Smiley Bone for his birthday last year?
You said you were gonna remind me.
I did.
Yeah, but it was such short notice.
I told you 2 weeks in advance.
2 weeks? I'm very busy, phone. How am I supposed to remember something like that for 2 whole weeks?
Forget it.
I'm not giving up what I have left for that caterwauling hobo.
Are you sure it's a map of the area?
Yeah, there's the mountains over there.
Come on, Smiley, just give him the map.
Not until I get my dollar.
How about the old gray mare?
My favorite. The old gray mare, she ain't what she used to be. 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 The old gray mare, she ain't what she used to be.
Here's a dollar.
Many long years ago. Not until I get my dollar.
I'll bet I can figure out a better way to use this.
Here, Smiley. Here's a dollar.
Thanks. Here's the map.
Let me see that. Let's see now. What? What is this? This map looks like it was drawn by a 5-year-old. It's worthless.
It's worth a dollar.
That's it. I'm gonna kill him.
Smiley, what's that noise?
Is it the townspeople?
Nope, no people. Just locals. Really neat, huh?
Ah! Phone! Save me!
Yuck! You guys still there?
Oh!
You guys still there?
Smiley Bone!
Where'd these stupid bugs come from?
Is it him? Is it the one we seek?
This is not the one. He doesn't bear the star.
Kill him anyway. He will be our supper.
Who's gonna be your supper?
The great red dragon!
Oh, my head. I must have been knocked out. Where is everybody? Did Phony Bone and Smiley leave me? As usual, I suppose it's up to me to save them and get us all back home to Boneville. Just once, I wish they'd try to save themselves. Say, where did this torch come from? Hello? This is one of Smiley's cigar stubs. If I can find more of these, maybe they'll lead me to Smiley. These cigar butts smell pretty bad. I wish Smiley had dropped breadcrumbs instead. Morning sure comes quick around here. It's green down there. I made it out of the desert. I don't know how deep that water is. I'm not sure that water is safe to swim across.
Hey, watch it! You almost stepped on me!
Whoops! Hello. What are you supposed to be?
I'm Ted. I'm a bug!
You look more like a leaf.
A leaf? That's an insult. Where's my big brother?
Hold on. I didn't mean any harm.
Well, I suppose you're okay. You probably just don't know our ways around here. Guess I won't have to call my big brother out on you.
Where am I?
This here's our valley. Pretty, huh?
Do all the bugs around here talk?
Sure. Why wouldn't we? Don't bugs talk where you come from?
Come to think of it, I don't think I ever asked them.
Well, you might want to sometime.
Have you seen my cousins around?
Cousins? What do they look like?
Well, sort of like me, I guess.
Ain't seen no one like you before, mister. Maybe Thorn has seen him?
Who's this Thorn? He's not another bug, is he?
Nah, Thorn knows just about everything in the whole world.
I don't know my way around here. How am I supposed to find this Thorn?
Thorn's usually at the farm or the spring. Getting to the spring is real easy. Just cross the river, follow the path, go to the bottom of the waterfall, and cross the river again, then cross the Possum Clearing. You can't miss it.
I don't see a way to cross this river.
Oh, you can't get across the rocks like I can you? Sometimes being small is an awful nice thing to be. Tell you what, my brother's on the other side of the river. If you want, I'll go over and get him to help out. What do you say?
Your brother? He's really going to be able to help?
Oh, sure. You just don't worry about a thing. What's your name?
Phone Bone.
Okay, Bone. Don't worry. We'll get you across this river in no time.
Thanks. I'll wait here for you.
Boing! Boing!
I notice you always seem to jump in threes. Little, little, big.
Yep.
Thank you.
Fella been asking to meet you. Seems a decent guy, that phone bone. We'll help him right out. It's a big old dead tree.
What's your point?
I need you over here.
On my way.
Cool. The bugs made me a bridge.
He's a good guy. Always looking out for him.
So you're, Ted's big brother?
Yep, that's me. And you better not mess with Ted, or you'll find out just how big Big is.
Oh, don't worry.
It's okay, big brother. He seems an okay guy.
All right, then.
Thanks for the help.
If you're a friend of Ted's, then you're okay by me.
I don't suppose you've, seen my cousins around here?
No, and I hope I don't. I don't like strangers in our valley, especially if they're troublemakers.
Aw, Bone's cousins aren't troublemakers, are they, Bone?
Right. Thanks, Ted.
Don't mention it, Bone. Happy to help.
Is this your, brother?
Oh, yeah. Big brother, this is Bone Bone.
Nice to meet you.
He's actually a real nice guy. Just don't make him mad.
I got anger issues.
Once he gets fired up, he'll charge at anything, won't you?
Yep, pretty much.
Hey, how do I get to that spring again?
You don't remember things real clearly, do you? Just down the path, across the pile of rocks, and through the possum's clearing. It's not so hard.
Be seeing you, Ted.
See you around, Bone.
Stay out of trouble.
Comrade, get off your fat butt and make us a cooking fire.
Well, well. Look who joined us for supper. Go start the cooking fire.
No, you call me fat.
No? What do you mean, no?
And it's not the first time you've done it either.
You will go nowhere, small mammal. We're going to make you into a nice stew.
Maybe I should just go.
You will go nowhere, small mammal. We're going to make you into a nice stew.
What? Quiche? What kind of food is that for a monster to eat?
Don't I get any say in how I'm cooked?
You get no say. We're the ones doing the cooking.
And I say, cook them in a quiche.
Oh, now see what you've done.
Do the other monsters make fun of you?
How did you... never mind that. It's not important.
They can be so cruel.
There are more of you guys?
Of course. We're only two scouts in a vast army that...
Comrade!
Prepare to be devoured, small creature.
What about that army?
Army? Who said anything about an army?
We do not know what you mean, small mammal.
We know nothing at all. And don't ask again, or we'll devour you quite messily.
We were gonna do that anyway.
True. But that's not the point.
Oh, right.
Onions are good in stews. Wait here while I get you some.
You'll stay right here, so we can chop you up for our stew.
Why do you keep insisting on the stew? I think a quiche would be...
Oh, not the quiche again!
You are one scary monster.
Well, I do try my best to keep in shape.
Unlike my...
You will go nowhere, small mammal. We're going to make you into a nice stew.
Is it so weird for monsters to like quiche? Your friend here can't be the only monster that likes it.
No one asked your opinion.
Well, he may have a point.
Enough! Let's just eat him now, please.
I don't remember the last time I had a quiche.
I'm only trying to protect your reputation.
You mean your reputation?
Have you no pride?
Oh, please.
Monsters do not eat quiche!
What do you know about being a real monster?
What did you say?
What? Me? Nothing.
You don't think I'm scary, do you?
Oh no, you're terrifying.
Truly?
Positively blood-curdling.
Well, I do try my best to keep in shape.
Unlike myself, is that what you are saying?
I'm not the touchy one.
So now I'm fat and touchy?
That's not what I meant. Can't we just make him into a...
Quiche?
Enough from you.
Well, maybe you should think before calling me fat.
Can't we just make him into a stew now?
And you keep insisting on the stew.
What is wrong with stew?
We eat nothing but stew. That's what's wrong.
Stew is a perfectly hearty and respectable dish for a monster.
I would still prefer a quiche.
Ugh, not the quiche again.
Why do you keep insisting on the stew? I think a quiche would be lovely.
Well, but quiche, it's just not right.
Get him.
Those rat creatures would have to be pretty stupid to follow me onto this frail little branch.
Stupid, stupid rat creatures!
Hello, small mammal.
What do you say, comrade? Shall we have a nice hot stew? We should meet him.
I say we bake him in a quiche. You know how much I like quiche.
It seems to me you boys have a short memory.
The dragon!
Thank you.
You let him get away.
What's that?
They were trying to eat me. If I was a dragon, I would have blasted them with fire. Can't you breathe fire?
That's right, kid. Never play an ace if a two will do.
What were those things?
You could call them rat creatures. Pretty far south, though.
Mr. Dragon, have you seen my cousins?
A short, angry one and a tall, lanky one with a banjo?
Yeah.
Sorry, kid. Haven't seen them.
You sure you haven't seen my cousins?
Yep.
You let him get away.
What's that?
Those things are dangerous. Why'd you let him get away? Never mind. Never mind. Sorry to bother you.
Shouldn't you be heading to the spring?
What?
Just cross these rocks and through the possum's clearing. Can't miss it.
Right. Thanks. I'm Phone Bone. Who are you?
We're possums.
Duh. Nice to meet you, Mr. Bone.
Have you seen my cousins around?
Are they weird looking like you?
That's not nice.
Well, he is.
Still not nice.
I don't think so, Mr. Bone.
Do you know the way to the hot spring?
Sure we do.
But we're not telling. We're not? Not till he plays a game with us.
Oh. Yeah. Wanna play a game, Mr. Bone?
Well, okay. What do you want to play?
What possums play best is dead.
How about hide and seek?
How about a story?
I don't want a story. I want to play.
Okay, okay. Let's play dead. So how do we play dead anyway?
Just give a roar when you're ready, mister.
And make it real scary.
Yeah, scary!
Can you show me the way to the spring now?
Nah, that doesn't count. That game is too short.
How about hide and seek?
Yeah, play hide and seek with us. Then we'll show you.
I just played a game with you guys.
Yeah, but that's a really short game.
Come on, Mr. Bone. Let's play hide and seek.
It'll be fun.
Come on, you guys. Why doesn't that count as a game?
It's too short.
Please, play hide and seek.
Please?
Okay, hide and seek it is.
All right!
Yay!
Okay, go close your eyes and count to 10.
One, two, three. Where are those kids?
You're so cold, it hurts. You are the coldest.
Gotcha.
Oh, man.
You get 8 more guesses.
Warmish. Warm.
Nope, nobody there.
7 more tries.
Cold. Warmish. Oh, you are hot.
Gotcha.
You found me.
6 more. You're way cold! Warm! Real warm!
Nothing.
5 more tries! Real warm.
Boo!
I thought this was a good spot.
I can't believe you beat us.
Yeah, we're really good hiders.
You want to play again, Mr. Bone?
Not now, guys. You said you'd show me how to get to the spring.
It's real easy. Just walk all the way over there and go through the bush.
The bush with the flowers all over it.
You sure you don't want to play another game?
Actually, can I ask you guys something? Where's your mom?
Oh, she's visiting with Mrs. Porcupine.
She told us to stay here.
And to stay in the yard.
See ya.
Hello? Don't be afraid. Come on down. We'll share the pool. Hello? Are you new around here?
Phone Bone, what's yours?
Pleased to meet you, Phone Bone. My name is Thorn.
Thorn? That's lovely. Thorn.
Thanks?
I like your brooch.
Oh, thanks. My grandma gave it to me.
Yeah. Where have you been? Seen my cousins?
What?
Have you seen my cousins?
Your cousins are here too?
My cousins are stuck in this valley too, but I haven't seen them since we got hit by that swarm of locusts.
You don't say.
One of my cousins is tall and kind of goofy. The other one is shorter and, grouchy.
I'm pretty sure I haven't seen them.
They're in this valley somewhere. We'll find them.
We will?
They look kind of like me. Yeah.
I haven't seen anyone like you around here.
Yeah, you seem very kind.
Oh, thank you.
I've been asking around about them, but no one's seen them. Not even that dragon.
Did you just say dragon?
Don't you believe in dragons?
No. Should I?
Hooray! Pretty soon I'll be back in Boneville, and I won't have to worry about dragons or this crazy valley again.
Look, I'd like to help you.
Well, let's go. No time to lose.
But I don't know a place called Boneville. I've never heard of it. There's a little village down the road called Barrelhaven. Does that help?
Oh. I don't belong here. My home is back through the mountains.
Maybe my grandmother can help. She's been in the valley longer than almost anyone. She knows a lot about different places.
Where can I find your grandma?
We live in a farm really pretty close to here. Come on, I'll take you there.
Okay, I'm ready. Let's go.
Okay, I'll help you pick up your stuff. What's this?
Oh, that's just an old map we found in the desert. Why are you making that face?
I don't know. Something about this map is familiar. It reminds me of a dream I used to have.
Are you okay?
Come on, Foambone. Let's get back to the farm and find Grandma.
Right behind you, Thor.
I can't believe Foambone would just leave me out here wandering around hungry and helpless. I'll bet he's back in Boneville right now, sitting in my house, eating my food. Just ate a stick an hour ago. What do you want from me? Look, I don't have time for you right now. Oh, cruel, cruel fate! Why have you abandoned your most beloved son? God, I pity me. Okay, I'll try to find some food. What the heck are you supposed to be?
I'm Ted's brother. I'm a big bug.
You look more like a big bloated leaf. Where can I get some food?
I think there's some apples on the other side of the river.
Look, I haven't eaten for hours.
What's your point?
I want those apples. Get out of the way.
You should mind your manners.
This is a waste of time. You seen a guy named Foambone around?
Who?
My cousin, Foambone.
Never heard of him.
I'm not surprised you haven't heard of Foambone. You don't seem to listen very well.
Look, you, we don't like troublemakers in our valley, and you're a troublemaker if I ever seen one.
Yeah, whatever. I've seen smarter amoebas!
Why, you...
Nothing but an overgrown aphid.
Why, you?
No bug alive can match my superior intellect. Good thing this log is here so I can cross the river. The name's Fonsible P. Bone, richest bone in Boneville. You've probably heard of me. I'm looking for a guy named Foambone. You seen him? Hey, you awake or what? Have you seen Foambone around? You know where I can get some food around here? All right, I'm out of here. How come they don't have any proper roads around this place? Send mail to a chipmunk.
Hello, Bone?
I don't have time for autographs, kids. I'm in a hurry.
Sorry, mister. We thought you were someone else.
We thought you were Phone Bone.
I don't look anything like Phone Bone. Wait a minute. Did you say you know Phone Bone?
Yeah.
Phone Bone's my cousin.
His cousin? All right!
We like Phone Bone.
He plays hide and seek with us.
Yeah, he would. If I give you kids a dollar, will you tell me where Phone went?
What's a dollar?
You're kidding.
No, really. What is it?
Oh, never mind. I think I feel ill. Come on, just tell me where Phone Bone went.
Not till he plays a game with us.
Let's play hide and seek.
Oh, brother. Fine. Let's make it quick.
Yay! He's gonna play with us.
You hide, and we'll find you.
Go hide.
Come on.
I already regret this.
One, two, three.
Tell us hot or cold.
Warm. Warm.
Where is he?
Cold. 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 I'm behind the big rock.
Alright!
Tell us hot or cold.
Cold.
I don't see him. Me neither.
Cold.
Where are you, Mr. Bone?
Warm. Forget it, kids. I'm out of here.
You have to beat us before we help you.
Annoying little squirts. You kids want to play a game or something?
Play hide and seek with us!
Oh, brother. Fine. Let's make it quick.
Yay! He's gonna play with us!
You hide, and we'll find you!
Go hide!
Come on!
I already regret this.
One, two, three...
Tell us hot or cold.
You're red hot. You're red hot. I'm behind the big rock.
Sure you are.
Cold. 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 Warm. I'm right here.
All right!
Tell us hot or cold.
Cold. Warm.
Gee, I wish we could find him.
Warm. Cold.
You're not too good at this game.
Warm.
Maybe he needs more practice.
I'm right here, you dumb kids. Warm. Cold.
warm.
All right!
Called.
Where is he?
Called.
I don't see him. Me neither.
I'm behind those rocks by the river.
Called.
Where are you, Mr. Bone?
Called. Called.
Gee, I wish we could find him.
Warm. Warm.
Look behind the big rock already.
Where do you think he really is?
Called.
Look, I don't have time for you right now.
Okay, go close your eyes and count to 10.
Mister, you new around here?
Who are you?
I'm Ted. I'm a bug.
Spare me the details, friend. I'm looking for a guy named Phone Bone. You seen him?
Bone? Oh, yeah, I've seen him.
You have? I'm saved. Where is he?
Don't know. Could be. He's at the farm by now.
Take me to Phone Bone at once.
Well, I don't know he's there for sure, but we can ask Grandma Ben.
Look, I'm starving here. Where can I get some chow?
Well, you might be able to get some food at the farmhouse. Grandma Ben takes to you, that is.
What's this Grandma Ben got to do with anything?
Grandma Ben lives at the farm, but she's not likely to help you if you give her lots of lip.
So where's this farmhouse?
It's not far. I'll take you if you want.
Come on, then. I ain't got all day.
I got to warn you, Grandma Ben's an old lady, and she might not take to your attitude much.
Don't worry about me, Pug. There ain't a woman alive who can resist my charms.
Okie dokie. Follow me.
Well, hello, Ted, dear. Who's your friend?
This here fella been asking to meet you.
Oh, he looks like such a nice young man. What is it you wanted, dear?
You got any food around this place?
Oh, are you hungry, dear?
I'm starving. You think I just walk around asking people for food for no reason?
Well, I might be able to find you something to eat at the house, if you're willing to work for your supper.
I am Funcible P. Bone, the richest bone in Boneville. I don't have to work for anything.
You poor thing. You must be far from home.
Cut the chit-chat, Grams. You got any food or not?
Well, that's about enough of that. Ted, dear, I think you'd better leave. I'm gonna tear this little fella apart from the inside out.
Yes, ma'am. See you around, pal.
So Ishmael finds the ship to sign up with, right? And he hears about this mysterious captain, but...
Yikes! Phone Bone! Save me! That crazy old lady tried to kill me!
Well, bless my buttons. What have we got here?
Hello, ma'am.
They're called bones, Grandma.
Sorry, dear, you can't keep them.
But...
No buts. I don't want any pets running around the house.
Grandma, they're not pets.
Can you milk them? If you can't milk them, they're pets.
That's it! I'm out of here!
Grandma!
Hold it, phony. Where's Smiley?
Smiley? I thought he was with you!
You haven't seen him since we split up?
The last time I saw that chowderhead, he was saying how cool it was that we were about to be pulverized by insects.
Gee, I hope Smiley's okay. Thorn thinks Grandma Ben can help us get back to Boneville.
Help! Help! They've destroyed my cousin's brain! Oh my God, they've already milked you, haven't they?
Look, do you think you can behave for just a couple of days?
Okay, okay, I'll be good. But if we wind up chopped to bits and buried in the woodshed, don't come crying to me!
You promise you aren't gonna get us in trouble?
Jeez! You want it in writing?
You have a piece of paper?
Oh, quit your whining. Why don't you introduce me to your good-looking friend?
Phony, this is Thorn. Thorn, Phony.
So, what have you been doing with my cousin? You got a little thing going on or what?
Phony!
No, huh? Figures. What'd you do, bore to death talking about Moby Dick?
Well, you boys can stay if you want, but you'll have to sleep in the barn and do a few chores before dinner.
Thanks, ma'am. We're happy to help.
All right, then. Phony Bone, you go to the hot springs and pull up a few turnips for dinner, then go up to the apple tree at the top of the waterfall and bring back a couple of apples. There's a path next to the house that's a shortcut up there. Phone Bone, you and Thorn can finish washing the potatoes, split a log for the fire, and bring two buckets of water to the porch.
Hold on. Why do I have to go back to the stupid forest and Phone gets to stay here at the farm?
You want to eat tonight?
Yeah, yeah.
All right, kids, get cracking.
Let's get that wood.
Okay, I'll chop the wood and you can finish with the potatoes.
What? Where I come from, what you just said is backwards. Chopping firewood is a manly thing. And since I'm the man, I'll do the manly thing.
Okay. What kind of manly thing is that?
Chin-ups! Wash the potatoes!
Hey, Bone, what you doing?
I'm just doing some chores for Grandma Ben.
That's right good of you, Bone. I'm sure she appreciates it.
Grandma is letting us stay with her and go to Barrel Haven with her tomorrow.
Hey, great! Barrel Haven sure is a swell place.
I need to split firewood, but this axe is stuck.
Oh yeah, you want some help?
Sure, Ted.
Okie doke, Bone. I think I got some friends can help you out. Go for it, boys.
Termites?
Don't mention it, Bone. Happy to help.
But...
See you around, Bone.
Now what am I gonna do? Now what am I gonna do?
I don't think that's going to help anything.
I guess this is the log I should split.
Hitting that with a rock is hardly productive.
Grandma Ben, do you mind if I use one of these corn cobs?
I suppose not. Just don't go spoiling your dinner.
Excuse me, Grandma Ben?
What is it, Phone Bone?
Phony and I are looking for our third cousin, ma'am. You wouldn't have happened to have seen him.
Can't say that I have. But if he's anywhere in the valley, he'll likely show up at the Spring Fair in Barrel Haven.
What's the Spring Fair?
It's the big event round here every year. Folks come from all over the valley for it.
I'll get back to work now.
All right, then. We'll have time to chit-chat over dinner. Now let's get those chores done.
There you are. Do me a favor. Don't mention your friend the dragon to Grandma.
Why not?
But I saw one. He had a goatee and a cigarette and big old hairy ears.
You were just seeing things. Dragons are make-believe.
You know, that's what he wants you to think. He doesn't want you to know he exists.
Actually, I just want her to think you're nuts.
Not a bad idea, but this corn cob is just a bit too big.
Yeah, what is it?
Can you help me out?
What do you need?
Can you breathe fire on this corn cob?
You sure you want me to?
Please, just breathe fire on the corn cob.
Okay.
Thanks.
Don't mention it.
Hey, there's a hole in this bucket. A perfect fit. Excuse me, Grandma Ben?
What is it, Phone Bone?
Finished with the wood.
I need more clean water.
Okay, kids. Go get the water, then.
No problem. Excuse me, Grandma Ben?
What is it, Phone Bone?
Here's your water, ma'am.
All right then, Phone Bone. Why don't you wait in the house till your cousin gets back?
Hey, kids!
Hey, guys! It's Phone Bone's cousin again.
Oh, no!
Just ignore him.
Say, that's a nifty spade you guys got there.
Thanks? It's our mom's shovel, and you can't have it!
Oh, come on. Can't I just borrow your spade?
It's not ours. It's our mom's.
So you can't borrow it.
Well, let me ask your mom if I can borrow it.
Mom's not here.
So you can't ask her.
So you can't have it.
What do you little runts need it for anyway?
We're making mud pies. And we're not runts.
I told you you should just ignore him.
What if I give you something for it?
There ain't nothing we want.
Besides, we told you, it belongs to our mom.
Yeah, we can't go swapping our mom's stuff.
You kids want to play a game or something?
We don't want to play with you.
Yeah, you cheat.
Yeah, cheater.
Don't you want to play dead with your Uncle Phony?
I don't feel like playing dead.
We don't want to play with you.
And you're not our uncle.
How about if I tell you a story?
Well, we don't want a story, neither. He can't cheat at telling stories.
What kind of story?
What kind of... it's a story about something really exciting that happened in Boneville, where I come from.
Well, maybe I'll hear just a little bit of the story.
Oh, brother.
I'll bet it's a dumb story.
Okay, once upon a time, there was...
A very clever Bone, full of great ideas.
Was that Phone Bone?
No, it wasn't Phone Bone. It was me. So anyway, this Bone had an idea. He decided to run for mayor. So he had this picnic. Everything was going great, until... someone didn't tie down the balloon properly, and the stupid thing broke loose. So the people were so mad over this silly balloon incident that they chased the poor Bone right out of their crummy town.
Oh, poor Mr. Bone.
Huh? What?
Yeah, that's real sad.
What do you mean?
Maybe we could just lend him the shovel.
Hey, I don't need your sympathy.
Well, okay. Here, Mr. Bone. You can borrow it for now.
Fine.
Please bring it back soon.
Grump, grump, grump. I should hurry up and finish gathering stuff before I go back. Yes! Thought you were safe and snug in your little dirt home, didn't you? Well, you're mine, turnips! Mine!
Again.
Yeah, you're the smart one. You shake your brains loose on that rock?
Why, you...
Nah, your mother was an aphid.
Why, you? It's you again.
Chase me, you mutant!
Why, you...
Stupid bug. Here's your stupid produce.
All right, then. Eat up, kids. Big day tomorrow.
The spring fair. I can't wait.
Grandma Ben, how long have you and Thor lived here?
Oh, we've been here a good long time.
I don't remember ever living anywhere else.
How'd you come to own the farm?
I prefer to keep the past in the past, Bone.
Sounds sensible to me.
What's your favorite part of the festival?
Well, every year I run in the great cow race against the fastest cows in the valley. Gets the old blood pumping.
You race against the cows, ma'am?
Sure do. The villagers love it, and it's good for keeping these old bones working.
You must be pretty fast to race against those cows.
Well, I just do my best and try and have a good time.
Oh, ha ha. There's hardly a cow in the valley that can beat Grandma on the 100-yard dash.
How many cows are usually in this race, anyhow?
Oh, usually about a dozen or so.
Uh-huh.
How fast does a cow run, anyway?
Not as fast as Grandma.
Now, dear.
I never thought of cows as the racing type.
Well, I don't know about Boneville, but around here they breed some pretty mean racing cows. Oh, Grandma, I almost forgot. I think Lulu Bell is feeling a little sick.
Oh, yeah? What's wrong with her?
She's just not eating like normal.
Okay then. I'll take a look at her after dinner.
Who's Lulu Bell?
Lou is one of Grandma's fastest racing cows. Sometimes, Grandma takes her to the Great Cow Race, as well as entering herself.
Do you go to the fair every year?
Oh, yes. We never miss it, and we aren't the only ones. People come from all over the valley every year.
What's the fair like?
Oh, it's so much fun. There are all sorts of people who come in to perform all kinds of tricks. I also love the booths where you can buy all kinds of amazing things from all over the valley. And of course, there's the big cow race.
What kind of things do you look for at the booths?
Oh, I usually just look. But this time, I'm gonna buy some dye and make a beautiful blue dress.
What do people do around there when the fair isn't in town?
Well, I only ever go for the fair. The Barrel Haven Tavern's very popular, I guess. And other than that, I guess they just work and live their lives. What do you do in Boneville?
The tavern sounds kinda neat.
It's a nice place. Around fair time, it'll be positively packed.
Oh, sorta the same, I guess.
Boneville sure beats the heck out of this place.
Oh, it's not so bad.
Oh, brother.
Aren't you going to eat, Bone?
Oh, yeah. Everything sure smells great, Thorn.
Why, thanks, Bonebone. Dig in.
Do you go to the fair every year?
Oh, yes. We never miss it, and we aren't the only ones. People come from all over the valley every year.
I sure hope we can find Smiley at the fair.
You worry too much. With my luck, I'm surprised it's taken this long to find that chucklehead.
Don't worry, Phone. If he's in the valley, I'm sure he'll show up at the fair.
He's your cousin too, you know.
So you keep reminding me.
Don't Don't worry, Phone. I'm sure we'll find him. What's he like?
You sure you want to know?
Phony, he's not that bad.
Easy for you to say. That guy exists just to make me miserable.
I think you like being miserable.
What? What?
I don't remember the last time kids came out to throw rocks at Smiley.
Do we really have to talk about this right now?
At least Smiley doesn't try to run one lousy scam after another.
Jeez, one lousy mistake and I gotta hear about it the rest of my life?
Maybe you'll think twice next time before you build an orphanage on a hazardous waste landfill.
What is wrong with that? That's two community services rolled into one. It was the ultimate tax shelter.
You never learn, do you?
I should have stuck with my first idea.
What, combining a slaughterhouse with a petting zoo? Oh yeah, that was brilliant.
Do we really have to talk about this right now?
Just forget it.
Sure, whatever you say.
I sure hope we can find Smiley at the fair.
You worry.
Don't...
Thank you very much for your hospitality, ma'am.
You boys did your part. I appreciate good help around the old place.
Slave labor's more like it.
Did you ever live in Barrelhaven?
I prefer to keep the past in the past, Bone. Well, big day tomorrow. Let's cut the chit-chat and everyone get some shut-eye. You boys can sleep in the house. Just make sure to keep it down here.
Good night, Phony. Good night, Phone Bone.
Oh.
Get up before I crush your heads! King Dog!
Sire, what are you doing here? May I kiss your feet? I wish I had some quiche I could offer you.
Quiet! I've had scouts out looking for you too.
You have? How flattering. I'm flattered. Are you flattered?
You two are starting to make me look bad. The Hooded One has summoned you both to a high council tonight.
The Hooded One?
Has something happened?
He has received word that the one we seek, the small, bald creature with the star on its chest, has been seen in the valley.
He has? But...
He was last seen in your territory. Come with me!
The rat creatures have surrounded the farm. Hurry!
Grandma, what's going on? Where are they?
They've surrounded the house. Hurry down here.
Where's Phony?
I don't know. He was gone when I woke up.
Little Squirt probably ran off.
Do you have a plan, Grandma?
I have an idea that might work. Okay, children, This is what we're going to do. When I say run, you run. Got that?
What? That's your plan? Run where?
Be sure you split up and don't let him catch you. I'll hold them all.
Okay, kids, run!
There's a back door. Come on.
Don't worry about me. I fought the rats back in the big war.
Split up? This is a terrible plan.
Hold it right there.
Why, look, Ted. It's a meeting of the new community leaders.
Ooh, a town meeting. Does we get to vote? I just love to vote.
Stay back, worm. Our numbers are too great. We are not afraid of you.
We?
Yes! I told you there was a dragon. I told you.
Grandma, are you all right?
Of course I am, dear.
The dragon saved us, Grandma. A real dragon. Look.
I can see. Hello, dragon.
Hello, folks. It's been a while.
Yep.
Come on, Ted.
What was that all about? Do you and the dragon know each other?
That's none of your beeswax, Bone. Now, come on. We're going into town where it's safe. And I bet we find that troublemaking cousin of yours there, too.
Yo-ho! Bone Bone!
Smiley Bone!
Hey, my little pal is safe!
Oh my gosh, I was so worried about you.
Hey, Phony! Bone Bone's here!
Hey!
Hey!
Once again, small one, your friends have come to you. But make no mistake, we will complete our transaction. You have been spared for now, Thunsible P. Bone.